Hello, I'm Olga from RubyMine, and in this tutorial we'll explore how to use TurboFrames and TurboStreams in RubyMine to enhance your Rails applications. The Turbo Framework is a part of the Hotwire suite. Hotwire simplifies web development by sending HTML instead of JSON over the wire. This reduces the amount of JavaScript code written and sent to the browser, and it keeps template rendering on the server. There are three frameworks: Turbo, Stimulus, and Strata. In this video, we're going to talk about Turbo. Turbo provides simple ways to deliver live partial updates to the page without using any JavaScript. It speeds up link clicks and form submissions with Turbo Drive, and it allows for real-time updates using Turbo Frames and Turbo Streams. The Turbo Rails gem is shipped by default with Rails 7, and in this tutorial we will use our Rails sample application. You can find the link to it in the video's description and try it yourself. As you can see, right now we can delete posts. Let's add editing. Open our view and add editing. Now, we're going to add the edit and update methods to the MicroPost controller. But first, we have to add the routes. I've already done this. You can find them here. But make sure you do it as well. Now we can add the methods themselves. Let's click on the gutter icon next to Dev Edit to create a template file. To edit a post, we need to render the existing partial MicroPost form, which we are already using for creating MicroPosts. And now, if we click on Edit, we'll be redirected to a new page. Turbo Frames can decompose the page into independent contexts. By using them, we can have in-place editing without reloading the whole page. First, we need to wrap our code in MicroPost HTML ERB with a Turbo Frame tag view helper. We'll be able to use this frame to specify which fragments of HTML should be replaced when the server processes a request. The frame tag helper expects an ID string as an argument, but in our case, we can simply pass the MicroPost object. Since we want to replace our MicroPost with a form to edit it, we need to edit HTML ERB to contain a matching Turbo frame. Please note that the frame IDs passed to the TurboFrame tag helper should match on both pages. Now, when we click on the edit link, the controller responds with a TurboFrame, and we see a MicroPost form instead of the MicroPost content, and we can edit its text. We've learned how to implement in-place editing. But what if you want to update multiple elements on the page with a single click? TurboStreams can help with that. They provide a way to send partial updates from the server to specific parts of the page using WebSocket or HTTP responses. To demonstrate how to use TurboStreams, let's add a way to unfollow a user from the main page. First, we'll add an unfollow link. I've already done that. That destroys a record in the relationships table. Now let's check what happens when we click on unfollow. As you can see, the post of the user we just unfollowed are still present on our feet, and the counter update is also incorrect. Why did this happen? If we look, we'll see that the sample app already includes some logic that allows users to unfollow other users. If we go to the users page and open, for example, Alice's page, we can unfollow her from there. And in that case, Alice's follower count drops and decreases right on the page. We have reused this logic, but we are on the feed page, not the users page. What should actually happen is that our following, not follower, count decreases. Let's implement that. First, let's add a root with an extra parameter. This parameter will let us pass the ID of the user for whom we want to update the counter. Then we need to update the path we'll be using for the unfollow link we've recently added. And now we can retrieve the user from the parameters. Let's open the controller and add our method here. And let's talk a bit about what this format TurboStream is. When you use Turbo, it adds a special TurboStream format to the request accept header. This happens automatically if you submit a form using post, put, patch, or delete methods. What does this mean? It means that the controller can respond in different formats. It can send a regular HTML response, or if it sees that TurboStream format, it can send a response specifically for TurboStreams. And in this particular code, the controller is set up to handle both. It can send back either HTML or TurboStream, depending on what the request asks for. And the method we've added handles unfollowing users from the feed. Now let's create a TurboStream view. And please keep in mind that all view files rendered from the controller via TurboStream should have a TurboStream ERB extension, like here. So, what does this code do? The controller needs to send some HTML in response to a request. Turbo lets us send fragments of HTML without sending the entire page. In this case, only those fragments are updated without a full page reload. Here we want to perform the update action on the following target. And we update the target with the latest user following count value. And this code removes all the posts by the unfollowed user from the feed. Now, unfollowing a user will update the following count and remove their posts from the feed in real time without a full page reload. For more details on how TurboFrames and TurboStreams work, check out our blog post. It also describes how to implement broadcasting, which might be useful if you want the update to be visible not just for the current user, but to everyone viewing the same page. You can find the link to the post in the video description. Thanks for watching.